Joining us now in Hot Copy, we have DFA Migrant Workers Affairs Under Secretary Eduardo De Vega. Yusek De Vega, good morning. Good to see you again, Yusek.
Good morning. Good morning. Yes, as I was saying, they're all accounted for.
Mm-hmm. Yusek, let me just confirm that the two Filipinos who are part of Doctors Without Borders, were they part of the first batch who crossed the Rafah border? Have you been in contact with them?
Yes. The Doctors Without Borders is in charge of them. The two have crossed.
Mm-hmm.
And they will stay in Arish, which is the town closest to the Rafah border. And soon they'll be going to Cairo. It's not the Philippine government which is in charge of them.
Mm-hmm. But have you been in contact with them in some way, Yusek?
Yes.
Any word from them?
Been in touch with them. And mm-hmm. They are in touch with their families. They're not going over to the Philippines. They're being sent to other countries.
So they're just going to stay there for a while. Any word from them, Yusek? How were they? What was the experience like? In case you have heard from them.
No, they are a professional organization and they'd rather not share what's happening.
You know,
what
right.
happened to them. Of course, eventually they will. Let's see what happens.
All right. I understand, Yusek. But how about the other Filipinos in Gaza? I understand there were about more than 100 in Gaza. Where are they now? And has the Philippine embassy there been in contact with them?
Yes, indeed. We lost contact with them, but eventually we were able to regain contact with mm-hmm. all of them, including 134 still left. 115 mm-hmm. now want to be repatriated.
115 out of 134. What are the reasons for those who don't want to be repatriated?
Well, they are, in effect, attached to Palestinian land.
Mm-hmm.
And that's partly because they are Palestinians themselves. I mean, they're mestizos, no? And they don't want to leave their spouses or their relatives. So that's it. But at least 115. Dati, before, it was just 70, 80, wanted mm-hmm. to go. Now 115. So that's still a positive development.
Of this figure, Yusek, how many are children and women?
The vast majority. By the way, I'm getting a call mm-hmm. from the embassy. Can I love to cut the call for the time because I have a call from the government. Yes, but 115 and we're waiting for Israeli authority for the Filipinos to be allowed in. And to allow them in, we're calling on our friendship with Israel and with Egypt so that the Filipinos would not have to wait too long because there's 7,000 who have to cross.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it's going to be complicated, but the intent is for all who want to cross, all foreigners to be able to cross, and we're counting on that.
Yusek, let me just confirm that the two Filipinos who are part of Doctors Without Borders, were they part of the first batch who crossed the Rafah border? Have you been in contact with them?
Yes. The Doctors Without Borders is in charge of them. The two have crossed.
Mm-hmm.
And they will stay in Arish, which is the town closest to the Rafah border, and soon they'll be going to Cairo. It's not the Philippine government which is in charge of them.
Mm-hmm. But have you been in contact with them in some way, Yusek?
Yes.
Any word from them?
Been in touch with them. Mm-hmm. And they are in touch with their families. They're not going over to the Philippines. They're being sent to other countries.
So they're just going to stay there for a while. Any word from them, Yusek? How were they? What was the experience like? In case you have heard from them.
No, they are a professional organization and they'd rather not share what's happening. You know, what
right.
happened to them. Of course, eventually they will. Let's see what happens.
All right. I understand, Yusek. But how about the other Filipinos in Gaza? I understand there were about more than 100 in Gaza. Where are they now? And has the Philippine embassy there been in contact with them?
Yes, indeed. We lost contact with them, but eventually we were able to regain contact with mm-hmm. all of them, including 134 still left. 115 mm-hmm. now want to be repatriated.
115 out of 134. What are the reasons for those who don't want to be repatriated?
Well, they are, in effect, attached to Palestinian land.
Mm-hmm.
And that's partly because they are Palestinians themselves. I mean, they're mestizos, no? And they don't want to leave their spouses or their relatives. So that's it. But at least 115. Dati, before, it was just 70, 80, wanted uh-huh. to go. Now 115. So that's still a positive development.
Of this figure, Yusek, how many are children and women?
The vast majority. By the way, I'm getting a call from the embassy. Can I love to cut the call for the time because I have a call from the government. Yes, but 115, and we're waiting for Israeli authority for the Filipinos to be allowed in. And to allow them in, we're calling on our friendship with Israel and with Egypt so that the Filipinos would not have to wait too long because there's 7,000 who have to cross. So it's going to be complicated. But the intent is for all who want to cross, all foreigners to be able to cross. And we're counting on that.
Salamat po. You say if you have to take a call, we'll wait for you until you finish your call. Thank you. Continue our discussion on the situation of Filipinos in Gaza. We have back with us DFA Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega. Yusek de Vega, good morning. Welcome back. I understand you have a bit of good news for us today.
Yeah, there's going to be another batch arriving tomorrow. I have their names. That was what I was talking about earlier with a colleague from Lebanon. Six Filipinos arriving at 6 o'clock tomorrow from Lebanon. And then I have the names, of course, I won't share them now. 45 Filipinos arriving from Israel. On November 6th. So that's good news. There are two Filipinos from the West Bank who crossed over to Jordan for repatriation, no? And we're working on that because the problem is they have no papers either for Jordan or for the West Bank to work. So it means, though, the reason why I say it's good news, it means the Kababayans natin are listening, more and more are listening to the call of the government for them to voluntarily repatriate. In the case of Gaza, it's mandatory, of course, although we can't force them. I believe I already mentioned that there's still 134, but more now want to go home. 115 want to go home, way up from the 78 just a few days ago. Now 115 want to return to the Philippines.
That's good to hear, Yusek. But just to situate the situation for us, for our audience, we're talking about six from Lebanon, but how many OFWs in Lebanon are there? And we have 45 from Israel who are coming back on November 6th. Out of how many?
All right. There are 30,000 Filipinos in Israel. There's no alert level in Israel other than alert level two, meaning we're just allowing Filipinos who already been to Israel to go back to work. We have a travel advisory, of course. So there's no obligation to be repatriated for the Filipinos in Israel because the authorities are already in control of their country. Of course, there's some problems in the north with Hezbollah. So the Filipinos there are actually safe. Of course, in the Middle East, you cannot always be guaranteed safety, you know. So we have invited them, for those who want to go home, to voluntarily repatriate. And there's over 120 who have gone home, plus about 45 more coming, and then still 100 more after that. So the numbers keep going up, and maybe they will keep going up in the next few days as we approach Christmas. So that's another powerful motivation for them to return to the Philippines. It's not a big percentage of the 30,000, but what's important is that they are safe. Now, in Lebanon, there's 17,500 Filipinos in Lebanon, of whom about 10,000 actually are undocumented. And that's why we have a limited number of Filipinos who have answered the call for voluntary repatriation under alert level three. The reason is they know they will probably not be able to return to their work. And even for those who want to go home, it's not just a matter of, well, signing up and then we'll buy them a ticket, they'll go home, because you have to get their permits. We are, however, looking at, over 200 have asked to return. Of whom 165 are being processed now. And the embassy specifically mentioned about 112 persons who we are targeting for repatriation in the next few days and weeks. So starting with the six.
the numbers will go up eventually. You know? So, and what's important is that, well, when I talk like this, you have to understand I'm a diplomat. Even as I am advising kami sa government, no, sa Department of Foreign Affairs and other agencies, advising kababayans to go home, we're still keeping hopes for peace to prevail, no, especially in Lebanon, because the reason why we put it in alert level 3 is that we have had experience where in Israel actually invaded Lebanon, and just like what's happening now in Gaza. So we don't want that to happen in Lebanon. There's always these skirmishes between the Hezbollah in southern Lebanon and Israel in northern Israel. And that's manageable for the Filipinos because it's not in Beirut. It's not where they're working, further up north. And we're hoping that it doesn't escalate. In fact, the whole world hopes it doesn't escalate.
Yusek, do we know how many Filipinos are living in the border of Lebanon and Israel, which could be, they could be susceptible to attacks?
That's what happened in Israel. There's roughly 91. Our embassy is in touch with them. Many have already evacuated, while the others are still there. Evacuated to safer ground up north. No? But they're saying that, well, they're used to this, and not one has been injured because they're not. They may be living in southern Lebanon, in right close to the border, but they're not in the places, obviously, where the Hezbollah, from where the Hezbollah is sent launching missiles or rockets towards Israel. So they don't feel that their lives are in particular danger.
Let me go back a bit, Yusek, to... Israel. Yes, let me go back a bit to Israel. You said that we're expecting more to come home from Israel. Have all Filipinos been accounted for? Because I understand there were four deaths in Israel, and I think there was a report that two were unaccounted for as of a few days ago. Have those two been accounted for?
Oh, unfortunately, we are treating them as likely being hostages. They're under the assumption that they are hostages because there's no record, there's no accounting for them in Israel. However, what it's not ideal to be hostage, to be made hostage. The alternative would be worse. There are still over 200 bodies being identified by Israeli authorities. People who were victims of the initial onslaught, initial attack on Israel on October 7th. We hope the two do not, none of the two Filipinos would be included there.
What's the profile of these two unaccounted for, Yusek?
Caregivers, one male, one female.
All right. Now, what about the four earlier reported to be dead? I understand one, the remains of one has already been brought back to the Philippines. What about the three others?
They, upon the request of the family, well, we're not going to reveal the details, but
we're not going to name them. We're not going to name them, but are they back?
They're being flown in. In fact, well, one is being flown in today.
Today?
Yes. And there are some, there's another one next week. So more details. I mean, we allow the family to breathe. And one still awaiting the final date of repatriation.
All right. Yusek, let me go back to Gaza now, because you did say more are willing to go back, more are being are signing up for repatriation. But how many are actually at the Rafah border waiting to cross?
There's at least 60 of them.
And, 60?
Yeah, so 57, but it changes from day to day. So I'm making the... rounding it off to 60, because they can't exactly keep staying in the Rafah crossing. I think you've seen images there in vehicles.
Yes.
It's not no man's land. Nobody wants to stay there forever. So some go to other parts of southern Gaza, which is safer than the north, obviously, where there are apartments, where there are places to stay. The point is, if the Israelis and the Egyptians say that now Filipinos will cross over, because I believe they will do it by nationality. Once we are told to cross over, they will be ready. Our ambassadors in both Jordan, which is in charge of the Palestinian Authority, and Egypt, which of course will be the team to put them in Egypt, say that if the Israelis say, all right, cross, they'll get them to cross at a moment's notice, wherever they are in southern Gaza now. So that counts.
And Yusek, allow me to please double check the names of the two doctors with Doctors Without Borders who have crossed the Rafah border. Darwin de la Cruz and Regidor Esguerra. Can we confirm from you if these are the doctors that who have crossed the border?
Yes, they had wanted not to this to be publicized, but it appeared online. So
yes,
from a list provided by the by some authority in Gaza, and it even appeared in the New York Times, including the nationalities of all. So well, I could say that. But out of respect for them, they are low profile. They are not giving interviews. They are waiting for the next assignment. They will stay overnight in Arish, which is the smallest, the closest city to the Rafah crossing. It's in the Sinai Peninsula. And it's still evening in Egypt. And then later today, they should be in Cairo, and the Doctors Without Borders, or the what you call Médecins Sans Frontières, the MSF, will assign them to different different places, because that is the commitment of that organization, which has won a Nobel Prize. And we're proud that two Filipinos are, at least two Filipino doctors are members of the organization, and were sent to a very difficult situation under the most difficult circumstances imaginable. And we salute. We salute our Kababayan doctors in the same way we salute all our Kababayans abroad.
Yusek, has the DFA been in touch with the families of these two doctors at least?
Yes. Well, not us. Not ourselves. They themselves. We are in touch with them. And
right.
They are in touch with their families constantly.
Now, Yusek, walk us through the plans for that the Philippine government has with respect to the repatriation of Filipinos in Gaza. Have you been in touch with the Israeli authorities, Egyptian authorities, or even with the Palestinian authorities to bring them home safely?
You bet. As for details, obviously, these are part of the diplomatic niceties, and we don't want anything to go wrong. Suffice it to say that our secretary is in touch with his counterparts, their foreign affairs, and our ambassadors there are hard at work.
But in the immediate, Yusek, what more steps are you going to take to talk to Filipinos in Gaza, and what kind of assistance do they need as of this time?
Well, we're talking to UN agencies, of course, about the humanitarian aid issue, because the problem is, okay, we'll assume, we'll be optimists, and we'll assume that the 115 will be able to cross within the next few days, hopefully by the weekend, towards Egypt, from where they will have 72 hours, according to the transit visa rules of Egypt, to be thrown somewhere else, because they cannot stay in Egypt. I mean, that's a deal. That means there will be still 19 left. And we will remain in touch with them and see what we can do to make supplies available to them.
Yusek, there has been a series of bombings in the past 2 days, one of which, a big bombing in the Jabalia refugee camp, hit twice in a row in 2 days. Are there concerns that there are Filipinos who might have been killed in these bombings?
There's always concerns, but remember, there are 9 Filipinos in Gaza City. There was a reported 6 who left yesterday to the border. It turns out, no, they are still in Gaza City, but they want to go to the Rafah border. And they are just not able to because of the bombings. But all of the 9, including the Filipina nun with the missionaries of charity, all of the 9 who are in Gaza City are accounted for. So we know that there is no Filipino casualty from those bombings.
That's good to know, Yusek, and we hope you can keep us informed about the developments in Gaza. We will be watching out for those developments, and we hope that everybody there gets to cross safely to Egypt soon. Thank you so much.